Hi guys, welcome back. We are in familiar surroundings. Back in the UK, back at Ultraflex. It's been a weird, interesting month, to be honest. Lots has happened, obviously. Went to Dubai for a whole month. It was amazing. Really liked it, and I'd recommend, to be honest, anyone to go if you love having a little bit of warmth, having a bit of beach lifestyle, but also being able to do your normal routines. If you coach or if you bodybuild, you can do all of that out there as well. And just basically, we lived our normal lives for 4 weeks in Dubai. So that was really nice, and I feel very grateful to have been able to do that, especially at the time that we were able to do it. I know that a lot of people didn't have access to gyms, and I felt in two minds about producing the content, because I wanted to do it because it's part of my business, but at the same time I did feel a little bit bad finding it out when people didn't have access, but it seemed to get overall positive feedback, so thanks for that guys. But it feels a bit nostalgic, like I haven't filmed with Gaz in a long time, so it's nice to catch up with Gaz. Obviously nice to be back in the environment. We caught up with Cuba and Meg a little bit as well. Obviously times are a little bit different at the moment. Cuba's now on the same split as Meg, they're prioritising their back. And I am on the same split as Lodge, and we're prioritising sort of our top line at the moment. So in this particular video, I'm going to take you through why I've set up my training in that way, why we're now hitting our pushing arms essentially at either a minimum of two times a week, but some weeks and some rotations actually works out that we're hitting them three times a week, which is the highest I've ever run my pressing volume, apart from once in like 2016. I ran a 6 day a week split, so bear in mind we're still training about five times a week at the moment. So I was training six times a week, and I was hitting my legs twice a week and my chest three times a week, and that split would write me off now. The balancing act that we're playing at the moment is managing the increase of frequency with volume. These two variables have to be very much controlled for us to benefit from the added frequency. We can't just ramp up frequency and expect to do the same amount of volume that we were doing in each session before. So it's about playing around with those variables and finding the right balance. Talk to you through a little bit of that later. A little bit of an update on me, where I'm at. I am now into my ninth week of the off season, which seems insane. Like, that's how long we haven't done a video, me and Gaz. The last one was the Italy video. So 9 weeks deep, I am about 14, 15 pounds up, depends on the day. And I was actually chatting to Loz in the car on the way here about like what my firm target is. So I believe in bodybuilding, it's very important to have a firm target. What am I actually aiming to achieve? And for me, it is however long it takes, whether I'm 30 or 40 years old when I do it, I don't care. I want to win the UK NBA, British Finals, the whole thing, the overall title. That's my big goal. That's the top of the tree. Obviously, I'd love to win pro shows and pro world titles, but I can't quite think about that right now until I've got that goal. So that means the most to me. So whatever I have to do to be able to get to that goal, I will do it. The last 9 weeks, even though I've been in Dubai, have been absolutely on point with it, what I need to do to get towards that goal. And one of the biggest things, looking back at my off-season 2 years off, was I got lazy. I got really lazy with some things that I should have been doing right. And this year really woke me up and made me realise that I can be better, and I hope that by producing these videos I can show you how to be better too, within your training, within your nutrition, and realise that there's gaps, and I still have gaps I can fill in my ability to be better. But I hope that again you guys can see where your gaps are and I can help you to improve them. So let's work towards this, whatever your goals may be. Maybe share them below, and we'll take you through a little bit of legs today, and also why I'm training with this new setup. So enjoy guys, see you in a bit. the biggest thing with this split, with the frequency at which we hit our pushing muscle groups, so our chest and our shoulders, and then for me also my arms. The arm volume for lots is actually very minimal. Doesn't really need huge arms for figure. But for myself, I definitely need to improve my arms, so the arm volume is high. Now, we're going to be putting a lot of joint stress through our body with this sort of frequency at which we're training the push musculature. So, with that being said, I've got to think about volume really, really in depth and realize what my minimum adaptive work is. So where can I force adaptation without essentially traveling into what will be an amount of total work that brings diminishing returns? So what I mean by that is I have more niggles than I have progress. And that's something that within your training you can quite simply analyze. You know, if you come away from a microcycle or a week of training and you're more fatigued and more hurt than you are in terms of comparison to your logbook numbers, then that's probably not the best setup. Or alternatively, if your logbook numbers aren't progressing as a result of you carrying fatigue from one session to another, then again, you need to revisit the total amount of work you are doing. So with the increase in frequency, we are literally doing one working set on things like high incline shoulder press, low incline dumbbell press, the Smith machine incline that I'm doing, and also the Nautilus shoulder press, just one working set. Because I needed to figure out where the amount of volume was that I could actually recover from first before I add any more, because it's a lot easier to add volume than it is to try and remove once you've already created too much fatigue. So I'd rather do too little and then add a little bit rather than do too much and have to pull back, if that makes sense. So that's the crux of it. Find an amount which works well for you, and this is a fluctuating variable. It's not always going to be the same. It's going to be a variable that one week might be a little more, one week might be a little bit less. And this is where your individual biofeedback, how do you feel day to day? How's your appetite? How's your energy? How's your focus? How's your logbook numbers? Those are the feedback tools you really need to look at. So as you can see, I'm loading the leg extension, the prime, on the middle pin. This will essentially just create a very even resistance profile. So you'll feel the load, both the lengthened and the shortened, fairly evenly, with a little bit of a drop off at the top, which is where our quads are actually weak. The quads in this particular machine, and any leg extension really, will go from a position of strength at the bottom, position of weakness at the top, where we can track to get them fully short. At the start of the workout, arguably you could challenge that shortened position by putting the weight on the bottom pin or even banding it. There's multiple ways you can do this. There's no real massive right or wrong. I spoke to Nick Gloff about where he'd prioritise the loading. I really respect Nick's opinion on things like this because he's incredibly strong. He's like a 7-plate squatter. And he said prioritise the middle and the top pin. So that's what I'm going to do for this run of training. I've also got the pin loaded one in my other rotation. So yeah, that's essentially how we're setting up leg extensions for this period of time. Let's go.
Yeah.
All of my working sets, even my ice, well, not all of them, but on most of them, because I really want to standardize execution on these moves where I can hold it a little bit longer in the contraction, especially whilst I'm, well, when I'm fairly strong at them and I'm almost at, you know, peak capacity of the machine. I want to be able to maximize my own execution so that everything can be as perfect as it possibly can be. This is something that we usually get a little bit lost in when we don't record, and we're quite easy to critique other people's training and say it's rubbish when you're not even recording your own. So it's important. They were good. Since being back at deadlifts, my erectors have been feeling it, so to speak. So my left erector got really tight after the 215 pull, and then the day after, I decided to periodize house moving with deadlifting, so superset really, and didn't go so well. Not great for fatigue management. The stimulus to fatigue ratio was a bit off on the Super King mattress. So as a result, my lower back is in tatters. Tatters, yeah. So I'm having to go a little cautious today. So I maybe could have tried harder on that last one to get it. But I know my hips might have left the pad, and then my lower back would have pulled again, so I'm just going to try and make it through this workout without really, really crippling myself. Now I've got a massage booked in tomorrow with Callum from Regen Physio, and that should be perfect. So, yeah.
Yeah. No. You want to be rich? You want to be poor? In the day, all of us selling.
Spoon up your face for black man like Brunson. From where the villain room blues play, the burgers room.
Yeah, that's what everyone loves. Yeah, I smell pussy. Yeah, you just want to go nuts. Yeah, I thought you was bad, bruv. Are you really been shot for? Yeah, you and pussy. Just what they get top for.
Let's go.
I'm to be on you.
We talking shit, they talking shit. We got no respect, pop on flex. We got no pistols, pop on rip. What you tell me tonight? They carry me out. You ain't gonna stop me.
I'm gonna
shoot you. You like me, so you're my prince. Who's gonna do just want to be
free? Take your time, take it all the way there.
You ain't seen a box store.
Big air in, full depth, come on, bury it deep, let's go. Drive, drive, you can go again. Drive all the way down, all the way down. Come on, here we go. Get in, and we go.
Now it seems that we're purchasing a dream, yeah.
Bit nervous for this, to be honest. So this is 7 and a 10. 7 for a 7 and a 5 last time for, I believe it was either 9 or 10. It was 10. So, just the continuous reps, which is scaring me a little bit. So I know how hard it is. But these are the things you've got to do, you know, you've got to do stuff that creates a novel stimulus, and that novel stimulus is usually a little scary, so. Gotta do a fair amount of these things across the off season to bring a better physique, so. Just gotta grit my teeth and do it. Or grit my Invisalign.
Like rappers in a kill zone, predator gets your brain on. These
lame
like
my home,
I'm flying in another time zone. We talking money, get the dial tone. I've been meditating, got the mind stone. And I can't go kiss about my bones and my little bro. I'm just so I have two friends, switch them sides and they got ghosts. Then I have hopes on my line, but doing the most. I've been through hell, but you can't tell the way I go. Get in the fat, then at the back. We never had,
yes, come on, stay
so I'm back. I never stressed. Nigga, you blessed. But that don't mean I won't do things that I regret. I can't forget about them times when I was broke. I can't forget about my goals and all my focus. I kept my trust and kept my place when they lost hope. I kept my focus, no emotions, ain't gonna show you. I regret. God, family, my friends, and the money is the only thing that count. Did that.
That's where it's really, really hard. Because I had 9. Maybe I had 10. But I took that pause at the top of the 8th. And I knew that wouldn't have been continuous. So I racked it. Still a good set, but I feel like I could have got more out of it. But I'm happy with that. Is that okay?
Big warm up. Big warm up.
Yeah, no, that was too many reps. Way too many reps. See, the thing is on this, the black band and increasing the resistance at the top, so making it harder at the top, actually really enforces the consistent reps because it almost makes you want to come back down. It's so hard at the top. So I really like this setup. It's something we tried months back. And I don't think we ever really went back to normal leg pressing. tell you what though, I think I should go back to doing some cardio, because I'm gassed, really gassed. It's not, so it's lots, like way too gassed for a session that's mostly under 10 reps. So yeah, maybe some cardio soon. Let's go. We weren't collaborative in this leg press last week, but I got, I don't understand why do we all do this as YouTubers? I don't get it. We're in this together, guys. We did this leg press last week. We got 12. So we will add 10 kilos and we will see if I can get, if I can do it, get 12 reps and max. That's the goal with this one. Pretty confident I will. I feel good today, actually. So for some reason, my lower back just felt like it exploded on the leg extension and then actually miraculously recovers from the hamstring curl. So pro tip, if you hurt your lower back, just go and do some sitting hamstring curls. Video, seeing as you've watched so far, to probably actually tell you what my split is. So I actually haven't said that yet. Gaz is probably like, what the hell? Like, this video title is literally just some sort of like teaser, clickbait. So anyway, the split. So we start off our rotation with pushing arms. Then we go into back and hamstrings, which is where we deadlift. And also do two sets of hamstring curls on that day, adductor. And then a pull workout. Then I rest. Then we go back to pushing arms, second rotation. And then we go into this session, which is legs. And then we rest again. So two on, one on. 2-on-1 off. I really like that. I'm recovering well from it so far at baseline volume. So we'll see where we go in terms of what I can add anymore. But I'm really enjoying it so far. I think that all the shots I need to improve will come up with this approach. I have to give credit where credit's due. I saw this split first run. I'm sure loads of other people, I mean, Gaz said he's run this split before, so. I saw Josh Bridgman running it with Callum Raystrick, and I saw that during my prep, and I was like, I really, really like that. So now, obviously, I've got an opportunity to sort of like, basically pick what I do, and I thought, let's go for it. So I'm enjoying it, like I said, and we'll see what the results are in the next few months. Jumper with this one. Oh, I need a few more pieces. A bit more body fat on the old midsection.
These days, I'm going to go out there.
definitely bringing the elbows up, since Keithy does all of his curls like that. So I think when Keithy has the arms he has, you've got to listen. So anyone that's doing biceps, aiding in that short position, just getting the bicep a little bit more short. Keithy has his rationale there, like it makes sense. So bring those elbows up a little bit, contract really hard, and you'll definitely get a little bit of a better connection. So I'm doing, like I said, I've said on other videos, but biceps pretty much every session. And today, it's a dumbbell curl. And I just aim to either improve execution a little bit on last time. See, it's never gonna be bad, but improve execution a little bit, or add like one rep. So today I got 12 on that first set, and I got 11 last time, so it's a win. But as long as I add those little things up, stay strict, and have the frequency, I should have bigger arms pretty soon, I think. And they're already a little bit bigger, inflammation, but hopefully some muscle soon. All right guys, so we've wrapped up the legs. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you very much for watching. Any questions, as always, please ask. And as I've said already, I appreciate any comments or suggestions on what you want to see from me in terms of content. I want to be able to stand out a little bit, and hopefully a lot of you follow me for like who I am and my personality, and hopefully, to be honest, hopefully a little bit more of my personality comes out now, because I must admit, towards the end of prep for everyone, you almost become a bit of a dulled down version of yourself, and I'm less like, I'm still sarcastic and still funny occasionally, but I've got less of it. So expect a little bit more of me over the next 6 to 12 months, and I'm ready to go, like, in terms of getting back on stage when I know for sure I can really, really attack the goal which I said at the start. So whether that's next year or the year after, we'll see. Thanks for watching, as always, appreciate it, and we will speak in the next video.